हेलो एवरीवन, तो क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे इज रीऑर्डर पावर ऑफ टूज। तो स्टार्टिंग विद द पॉजिटिव इंटीजर एन, वी हैव टू रीऑर्डर द डिजिट्स इन एनी ऑर्डर इंक्लूडिंग द ओरिजिनल ऑर्डर सो दैट द लीडिंग डिजिट इज नॉट जीरो एंड वी हैव टू रिटर्न ट्रू एंड इफ द रिजल्टिंग नंबर इज पावर ऑफ टू। सो व्हाट डज इट मीन बाय द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट सपोज द नंबर इज 14230, इफ यू पुट इट लाइक दिस देन द जीरो विड कम एट बिगनिंग सो इट वुड बिकम फोर फ्रॉम फोर डिजिट नंबर टू थ्री डिजिट नंबर। So we won't want this, so alright, so that's why this case is mentioned over here, alright. Now the other case is that when we, suppose this is a number, alright, the two combinations we get from this is the number itself, that is 64, and the next number that is 46, alright. So 64 is power of 2, so we can return true in this case. Since 46 is not, we can return false, alright. I hope the question is clear and why the constraint for the zero is provided, because it will just reduce the number to n minus 1 digit number, alright. If it's a 5 digit, it will reduce it to 4 digit, so on and so forth, alright. So we don't want that, but also we want any arrangement, any such arrangement that is possible from the given number n, that should be a power of 2, alright. So yeah, that's the question over here. And let's see for the constraint given to us. So the constraint given to us is n would be from 1 to 10 to power 9, so n couldn't be 0, so it would be greater than 0 always, all right. So let's and it will range up to 10 to power 9, all right. So let's see how the approach for this question will be doing. So this is the question that is given to us. So a very good approach, or you could say the best approach or the intuitive approach, is that suppose a number is given to us 645, suppose that, all right, we have to check its power of 2 or not, all right. Any rearrangement or the any permutation of the given number would contain, like it could be 456 or it could be 465, so on and so forth, but you can see the count of digits always remain the same. It contains 16, 14 and 15. Alright, similarly this, so alright, so what we get from here is when we rearrange any number, the number of digits of digit remain same, alright. So this is the approach that we're going to use here. So what we are going to do is we are going to make a hash, because the digit would be 0 to 9 only, all right. So we will make a hash and we will store the count for every digit, and that count will be compared to the power of 2. So the power of 2 will be from 2 to power 1, that is 2 itself, to 2 to the power 31, all right. We will look for these power only, because this is the range for a sign bit integer. Int value, so int value can range from this only, that's why we are using this value. It's very important to know that why we are going up to 2 to the power 31, why we aren't going any further with from that. The answer for this is that the value of int can range from 2 to power 31 only, all right. If further that, it would be 2 to power 32 minus 1, that is int dot max value. So 2 to 2 power 32 can't be stored in an int variable, so that's why we are checking for 2 to the power 31. Alright, for every 2 to the power, we will check these digits and compare it with our original array, and if the count of digit is exactly the same, then we can say, then we'll return true, alright. So I hope it's clear, because if the count is same, because the order doesn't matter, we'll say that it is any permutation of it, alright. So what matters is the count, not the occurrence or the where they are occurring. So that's why we are storing in a little hash array like thing, and yeah. So I hope it's clear. The one main point is that if we arrange a number in any form like this 645, 465 and any, the count of digit always remain the same. Suppose the number is 6645, alright. So 4656, it contains 26 and 1415. So this is the approach that we are going to use, and what we'll do is then first of all we'll count how many occurrences are there, and after that we just compare it from 2 to the power. So 2 to the power can be from 2 to the power 1 to 2 to the power 31. Why 31? Because the integer dot max value, that is the maximum value that can be stored in the int, is 2 to the power 32 minus 1. Alright. So it can't be 2 to the power 32. So alright, so we have taken till 31. I hope it's clear. It's very important point for this question point of view. And rest or everything is clear. Let's see the code, and if someone has still difficulty with it, would get much more easy to understand. All right, so let's see the code. Yeah, so here is a code. It's a very simple code I have written. All right, so what is this function do? This count the occurrences and stored in an array, and which array is returned. All right, so this array is called as soon as the number is passed. Alright, so when the number is passed, the function is called, and the value returned array would be stored in A. Now from 0 to 2 to the power 31, because the numbers are starting from 1, so 2 to power 0 is equals to 1, so we have to look for this case as well. Alright, so 2 to power 0 to 2 to power 31. Alright, I hope it's clear why we are going from 0 to 2 to power 31. Not much further, because int can store only up to that value, and we'll see that if array dot equals is equals to the count in that array and also in the array given to us. If it's the count is same, we'll return true, and if the count is not same, we'll return false. All right, in the worst case, it will took up to o of 31, because the loop is running 31 times and comparing them, and this just take O of n times. So O of n is the running time complexity, and since we are storing the digits, so the space complexity would be O of n as well, because we have to store the count. So okay, so in the worst case we have to, so it would be it won't be O of n, because it would be stored in an array that contains only letters 0 to 9, so every time we need a constant space of 10. Alright, so no extra memory space is required, so it's take constant amount of memory space and O of n running time complexity. I hope it's clear to everyone. Let's try to submit it. As you can see, it's submitted and accepted. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like this video, share it among your friends, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.